Good morning and welcome. Unfortunately, I cannot yet comment on the Open España because the day of recording is Saturday. I know I published this on Wednesday, but we're not clear yet on the result of the tournament. Nonetheless, it is time for a new video, and today I would like to talk to you about the different abbreviations that we could use in business English. So today's video is dedicated to that. Welcome to a new video, and this is TJ English Golf. The first abbreviation I would like to mention today is ASEP. We pronounce it as ASAP. Now, what does it mean? As soon as possible. So this usually comes with an instruction to do something ASAP, as soon as possible. The second abbreviation, N/A, which means not applicable. Then we move on to the next one, which is maybe a little bit more familiar, FYI, and we pronounce it in that way as well. We can use it in conversation, FYI, for your information. So I'm informing you, for your information. The fourth abbreviation, BTW, which means by the way. So I want to remind you of something, or I would like to shift the attention of the conversation to something else. This one, by the way, is mostly used in written English, so for emails. BTW, by the way. The next one is EOD, end of day. So this is used to indicate that something needs to be done or should be finished by the end of the day. The seventh abbreviation is similar to one we had before, and this one is COB, which means closing of business. So this refers to when you close or when the day ends at your company. So this is used in similar situations as EOD, so when you need something to be done by the closing of business. Then the next one sounds similar, but it is obviously not. COD, D of Denmark. And that means cash on delivery. This is one that we typically use in the financial sphere. So it means that you will be paid when the goods that you need to deliver are actually delivered. Then we move on to number 9, TBD, to be decided. So you're having a conversation, again, in email on something, and you don't know what to do yet, so you call that to be decided, TBD. All right, and we move to the last one, which you may have heard. It is typically related to events. And it also has something to do with courtesy. RSVP, which is actually not English, because it means répondez s'il vous plaît, which is French for please respond. Typically, on an invitation, it would say RSVP, which means that the person inviting you to the event would like to know whether or not you're going to the event. And it is very polite to actually respond to the invitation, whether you are going or not, it doesn't matter. Please respond. All right, that's it. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope that these abbreviations help you in your daily work life, in your emails, in spoken English, whatever. Go check my website if you would like to see them written again with a little bit more explanation as well. Link down in the description. And that's it. Obviously, you can find all the other links as well. And yeah, thank you very much for watching. Until next week. But until next week, don't forget to practice.